Anderson driving number 74. fight off the challenge of Billy Moyer. He did it. One more lap. Oh, could have been some feature races. And he's done pretty much the same thing at the Cedar Lake Speedway, so he's going to be something to watch. That Bush Beer, McGee. All right, Steve Francis, number 15. Larry Seekers of the Orange, number 8, is leading them around.
Thank you.
in hot laps earlier. Got the other engine in there. Everything's cool for number 83, Billy Craft. By the way, 1988 winner of the 18th annual World 100 at Eldora Speedway over the green. There it is. And here we go. this time they are showboating, and we're going to come back at them. Do you betcha? They put on a show. We've been waiting to see it. Show your appreciation. They can't hear you, but they can see you, and they're returning the wave. There they are, race fans. The greatest late model stock car showing. $10,000 bonus. Anyone else win? That's history. Eighth car is this. They will lap one more time. Ready for the green. Get up and go on the pole once again. Hugh Parker. Hugh Parker in that number 10 racing machine. Out of Sacramento, Wisconsin. And for transport, Kevin Thompson, number 39. Last season coming up. All right, let's see who gets on it. 21, Billy Moyer, and Scott Lookwood, number 18, your top three finishers. Trying to get the official results for you, but man, oh man, what a charge. Mitchell gave it his all in that number three turn, but couldn't come away. You could kiss off and go, but he kissed off and got banged. As you can see, dropping the front end, but he sure gave it a drive.
Trying to drop kick somebody like that.
Quite a ride right down to the wire. We're going to be going to pit side with Greg in a moment, interviewing the winner. Order to finish again, Kevin Thompson, number 39, 21, Billy Moyer, Jr., number 18, Scott Blomquist, and fourth place by an eyelash, Mitch Johnson in double O. Finishing fifth place, number 75, Larry Phillips. Super race man, let's give that man the charge of his life because he done won a whale of a job. Winner, the late model feature, Kevin Thompson of Van Horn. What a job! All right, Greg, take her away.
All right, thank you very much. Kevin, congratulations on a super job.
Thank you.
You know, a lot of people say it's easy when you start up in the touring, but that's not always the truth. We hung in there, of course, we had a lot of lap traffic to get through towards the end of things, and it was flying, all of it.
Hard to go around this track, that's right on there.
Did you have any idea when you first showed up here tonight that you might be up here? There you go, snap on, hat on. Did you have any idea that you might be up here in the victory circle at the end of tonight's program when you first showed up tonight?
Oh, not at all. We're hoping for the top 10, maybe.
That's a few $1,000 to take home with you instead of tickle you.
Yeah, you bet.
Are you going to be able to follow the circuit anymore?
No, we're going to stay at home the rest of the weekend.
Got a lot of local racing to do. Well, anyhow, Kevin, congratulations. You did a super job. You got a mess of fans here tonight. Again, on behalf of the Crooks, the World of Outlaws, super job. Look at it.
Doggers from the other parts of the country, didn't we, huh? We done all right. Way to go. Kevin Thompson of Grand Forks, Mike Hobie, winner of the feature for the WISSOTA Modifieds, out there as well.
What we'd like to do right now is present Kevin, of course, with the trophy, the Cedar Lake Speedway World of Outlaws Snap-on Fools Budweiser $150,000 tour show. Again, Kevin, just a super job, and right now Gary Cook is behind you with the jacket. I'll grab this, get jackets and hats and crocs and trophies and everything else. Get some pictures taken here.
Come on, give him a big more noise than that, folks. Give him a big hand. What a super job he did. Happiness is a thing called Kevin Thompson. I've met tonight.
One more time, ladies and gentlemen. Lap 10 for Kevin Thompson. A World of Outlaws feature winner.
Mike Hobie, Mike Bartke, Hobie, the WISSOTA Modified winner in a moment. How much sleep do you think Kevin Thompson's going to get tonight?
All righty, ladies and gentlemen, right now we're going to move back and talk with Mike Hobie. Mike Fisher, the winner in the WISSOTA Modified event tonight, and we should get out of the trackside right afterwards. We'll get to the end of the night. Good feature for you.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun. We had a good time. The car was really well. Going in.
I got to ask you one real stupid question. Of course, most of us are familiar with, I think, what, the 350 claim on WISSOTA Motors. The top guys, say the top six of them, are they actually going to tell me that they've got 250 or less? Paraphernalia and trophies and that sort of thing.
Thanks, everybody.
Let's hear it again, ladies and gentlemen.